So we're here at the mall in Montclair, which is called either Montclair Plaza or Montclair Place, depending on which sign you're looking at. The thing about this mall is it seems to constantly be under renovation.
Yeah.
But there's one thing that seemingly has never been renovated, and that is this 90s-style Disney store right here. And right now, when everything in Disney is constantly being rebooted and upgraded and replaced and renovated,
yeah,
it's kind of cool to have this just pure nostalgia bomb right here. What are your thoughts, Allie?
It's cool. It reminds me back at the mall at Crystal City that my parents take me to all the time, including the rocking Donald Duck up in front.
And I'm sure if you went back to the Disney store in that mall right now, it would look like the, you know, lame, sleek, modern Disney stores that all the other Disney stores look like.
In fact, it does, yes.
But this one is untouched. This one is still pure 90s nostalgia. This one isn't the lame, live-action remake of a Disney store.
Shall we go inside?
Let's see how it looks on the inside. Yes, it may be modern Disney merch, but it's vintage Disney decor, just the way we remember it from when we were kids. Well, sure, it all seemed a lot bigger when we were kids, but you can't completely live in the past forever. You can just take nice visits to the past. And now I can riff on the things I wasn't snarky enough to riff on as a kid. Oh, Willy doesn't get to be a statue, huh? Just a forced perspective backdrop? Disney's always belittling the giants. Wait, why is Goofy's dressing room stuck in the broom closet? Just because he's comic relief? Wouldn't it make more sense for Donald to be in the broom closet because he's the one the world craps on? Pumbaa looks either exhausted or stoned. And since he's Seth Rogen now, I'm gonna say both. Of course, there was something I never saw in a Disney store as a kid. Toys of Disney characters tying into a non-Disney movie. Spider-Verse was just so good that Disney can't ignore it. Hey, I have no complaints about seeing Spider-Ham among the other cute talking animals. It turns out not only is this one of the few Disney stores that didn't get remodeled, but it was the first of the two locations of the short-lived Mickey's Kitchen experiment. The other location being Schaumburg, Illinois, which I learned all about from Mike Carlson. But now, the thing that makes this Disney store special is they left it alone for decades instead of updating it. Now this store fills me with warm and fuzzy feelings all because of corporate neglect, or at least corporate inaction. Is that weird? Eh, I guess no weirder than having any sort of warm and fuzzy feelings about a retail space designed solely to overcharge you for mediocre wares that just happen to have iconography associated with art that resonated with you in your formative years when you were too young to think critically, but now you've taken it on as part of your identity. But hey, as long as we're stuck in this capitalist hellscape, I'll take whatever warm and fuzzy feelings I can get. On an unrelated note, have you considered supporting my Patreon?